bam, it's true.
So, we've now learned how to find the derivative of a tangent line and just find derivatives using the definition of derivatives, and started using some basic rules of differentiation to find, well, again, derivatives. And remembering that a derivative is an equation or a function, excuse me, a function that will give us the slope of the original function at, you know, almost all values of x. Now remember, we couldn't find the derivative where the tangent line was vertical. We couldn't find the derivative or the slope of a curve at a sharp bend, so there are some special cases that you want to be aware of. But what I want to do in this video is draw some functions, functions like this first example, f of x is equal to x squared minus 7, and compare those functions to some plausible drawings of the derivative. So we have f of x is equal to, and these are just going to be sketches, f of x is equal to x squared minus 7. Well, this is a parabola opening up that has a vertical shift down of 7 units. So this parabola looks something like this. And down here at the y value of negative 7, we have its minimum value, or its vertex. Well, f prime of x, and I gave for this first example an actual equation, f prime of x, or the derivative of x, now that we know some of our basic differentiation rules, is going to be just 2x. Well, if I want to graph this derivative on the same xy axis as the original function, we have, it's just 2x. It's, you know, basically like y equals mx plus b. So this equation is just a line. It has a y-intercept of 0 and a slope of 2. So we're going to go up 2 and over 1. And I'm just sort of, again, sketching this very, very roughly. So here is a rough sketch of what my derivative should look like, with a slope, you know, approximating the slope of 2 and a y-intercept of 0. Well, remembering that the derivative gives us the slope of the original function, let's remember that it's, or just look at this parabola. This parabola is going down to the right. For every x value to the left of 0, or in quadrants, 2 and 3, the parabola is going down to the right. So the slope of any tangent line that I draw, I don't want to mess this up too much, but if I were to pick this point right here and draw a tangent line, that tangent line would have a negative slope. That is why this blue line is below the x-axis, representing that, you know, my derivative, the y values of my derivative, when I take the value of x, let's say, you know, whatever, this point here, that negative x is going to give me a negative slope. And indeed, along this line, let's say right here, for that particular value of x, right there on the parabola, it's going down to the right. The slope of the parabola is negative, and indicated by the derivative being below the x-axis and giving us a y value that is negative from the derivative equation, f prime of x is equal to 2x. And the parabola continues to have a negative slope until you get to its vertex, in which case it stops falling and starts to rise. Well, at that particular point, right at the very vertex, if I were to draw a tangent line, and I got some colors up here, if I were to draw a tangent line through the vertex, or at, you know, a line that is tangent to the parabola at its vertex, it would have a slope of 0. And thus we see the blue line, which is a sketch of what the derivative is, it is passing through the x-axis at 0, 0, or its y value there is also 0. So negative tangent lines, negative slopes, the derivative is below the x-axis. We have the vertex, the slope there is 0. This is a smooth continuous curve. That derivative there has a value of 0, and then it starts to rise. So our derivative at this value of 0, for all x values less than 0, my derivative is negative. For all x values greater than 0, my derivative is positive. So my derivative went from being negative to positive. I found a relative minimum within the original graph. Over here, I have what is probably a cubic function. And I want to pay attention to, again, this relative minimum and this relative maximum. So, and I'm going to look at this original function here and try and sketch what the derivative may look like. Well, as I go along here, the graph is falling. So at any point that I pick along this section of the curve, my slope is going to be negative, which that means my derivative has to give a negative answer or a negative value. That means my derivative is going to be below the x-axis. So my derivative is going to be below the x-axis all along here until I get to this point right here, which is a relative minimum, and the graph starts to fall and start to rise. So right there, my slope of my tangent line, if I were to draw one, let's just make a tiny one there, my slope there is going to be zero, and everywhere to the left, my slope is going to be negative, and everywhere to the right, my slope is going to be positive. Now, I don't know how high this derivative is going to go, but I know that from this point on, my graph is rising, so my derivative values must be positive, thus my sketch of the derivative, a possible derivative, has to be above the x-axis. And my graph begins to rise, or continues to rise, until I get to this orange line, and at that orange line, my tangent line, or the slope at the curve there, again becomes zero. So my derivative is going to be above the x-axis, representing that I'm getting positive values from my derivative, which again gives me slope, and my slope is positive, so my values, my y values from the derivative are all going to be above the x-axis until they get to this orange line, which again is going to give me a derivative value of zero because my slope there in the actual function is zero. And it begins to fall again, and so this blue line is a visual representation of what could be. And the only thing I really messed up is or not messed up, but haven't paid attention to is how sharply does it fall? You know, what is my maximum slope between these two points? So how high does this blue derivative graph go? But it is an idea, trying to give you an understanding of the relationship between the graph of the derivative and the graph of the original function. Now before I move on to my next example, this is a relative minimum. My slope my slope leading up to my relative minimum is negative, and then my slope becomes positive. So at this green line, we could call this my value of A. To the left of A, my derivative is negative. To the right of A, my derivative becomes positive. So when you fall and then rise, when your derivative crosses the x-axis and it's negative to the left and positive to the right, that derivative, that sign change on the derivative, is showing you that you found a relative minimum value. Unlike the relative maximum, where my derivative is going to be positive, see my blue line is above my x-axis again because my slope is positive, and here my relative maximum, the graph starts to fall, and my derivative therefore has to fall below the x-axis, representing those negative y values, or those negative slope values. So here my derivative to the didn't want that chalk anyway. My derivative to the left of B is positive. My derivative has an x-intercept. That's a slope of zero. And then my derivative becomes negative. So positive, then negative, is a relative, you're finding a relative maximum with the derivative values, the sign changes. And over here, my last example, is I got a graph falling, so it has a negative slope. At some point here, my tangent line becomes horizontal, or I get a slope of zero. But then instead of rising back up again, and this being a relative minimum, it just starts to fall again. Well, what would my sketch of my derivative look like for this particular graph? At that particular x value, we could call it A. The derivative is going to be negative because my graph is falling, so my derivative would need to be below the x-axis. My derivative will touch the x-axis, representing a slope of zero, because my y-value is going to be zero from the derivative, which gives me slope, and then it starts to fall again. So this could be a plausible sketch of what my derivative could look like for this function that falls, becomes horizontal, and then falls again. And again, where I have this value of A, to the left of A, my derivative is negative. To the right of A, my derivative is negative. So just because your derivative, if you find an x-intercept, or find your derivative, set it equal to zero, and solve for x, when you find the x-intercept, you're not necessarily going to have a relative maximum or minimum value at that value of x, because the graph could just start to fall again, and we see that there's no sign change to the left and the right of a. To the left of a, my derivative is negative. To the right of a, my derivative is still negative, even though in between there I had an x-intercept just touched. So I hope that helps you give you a little bit of better understanding of the derivatives and how it relates to the original function, and how you can look at these graphs and see the comparisons between the two, and maybe even help you find some relative maxes and mins. I'm Mr. True. Bam! Go do your homework.